Dear students, in this lecture video, so we are going to explain about influence lines and how to draw influence line diagram for simply supported beam subjected to single point load. So as you know that there are different types of loads which will be acting on the structure. For example, dead loads. Dead loads are those loads which do not change their position during the life of the beams or any member. Live loads. Live loads are those loads which can change their position during the life of the beams or any members. So another important type of loading is moving loads, or it is also called as rolling loads. So in this entire module, we are going to discuss about moving loads. The loads due to the rolling wheel loads on account of the vehicle passing over the bridge may act at the critical points producing the maximum effect. For example, if a vehicle moves over the bridge, say on the member AB, the wheel load or a load W which occupies a different locations, say the load may be near to point A or it may be at the center or near to point B. At these different locations, the responses such as reactions, bending moment, shear force also vary. The variation in structural response expressed in terms of reaction, shear force and bending moment due to rolling or moving loads. So ultimate aim in this is to find out the variation in reaction, shear force and bending moment and to draw the influence line diagram for the same. To identify the position of loads for maximum shear force and bending moment at specified sections, influence line diagram can be used. So it is written as ILD. The effect of loads that occupy different positions on a structure can be studied by means of influence lines. So what is the importance of these influence lines? So it is important for design of the member and to find out the what is the maximum stress or which location the stress is acting, which is required for the design. The graphical representation or a curve depicting the values of the desired quantity for various load positions is drawn and is used for calculation. Such curves are called, or lines are called, influence lines. Say for example, so we need to calculate what is the shear force or what is the bending moment at different locations. Say at B, what is the bending moment, or at the center, what is the bending moment, or at a distance, say from A or from the X, what is the bending moment. So hence we have to calculate at different locations what is the value in terms of bending moment, shear force and reactions. Then we have to draw a curve for that. This is called influence lines. A curve or graph that represents functions like reaction to support, shear force at a section, the bending moment at a section of a structure, etc. for various position of the unit load on the span of the structure is called influence line diagram. So let us solve an example. Influence line diagram for reaction, shear force and bending moment for a simply supported beam subjected to single point load. So this is the example. The beam is AB. The unit load is acting at point C and it is moving from left to right. And unit load is located at a distance of X from A. So hence distance from C to B is L minus X, that's total span is L. Let us assume that reaction at A is RE, reaction at B is RP. So we have to calculate the reactions RE and RP. To calculate the reactions, we can use equilibrium conditions. The first one is summation V is equal to 0. So RE is upward force, hence it is taken as plus. RB is also upward force, hence taken as plus. One unit force is acting downwards, hence it is taken as minus is equal to 0. Or if I rewrite this, RA plus RB is equal to 1. Then taking moment about B or applying the third equilibrium condition as 0. Moment about B as 0. So moment is force into perpendicular distance. So RA into L. So RA is the force, L is the distance, and it is this force is clockwise about B, so hence it is taken as plus. Then 1 is the force, distance is L minus X, 1 into L minus X, and this force is anti-clockwise about the point B, hence it is taken as minus is equal to 0, and RA is L minus X by L. If I substitute this RA value in this above equation. So I'm getting RB as x by L. So now RA we called as plus, RB also plus. Whatever the assumption we made initially, that is upward force, it is correct. So RA is a reaction which is acting upwards. RB is a reaction also which is also acting upwards. Then, so ILD, influence line diagram for reactions. We know that RA is L minus X by L, RB is X by L. So at X is equal to 0, so that is at point A, RA is L minus 0 by L is equal to 1. We are substituting in the above expression, X is 0 here, so it is 1. Then at X is equal to 0, RB is 0. Then at X is equal to L, X is equal to L means, so that is at the point B. X is equal to L means at point B. So we are considered from left to right here. L minus L by L, so it is 0. So RB is L by L, it is 1. At C, that is under the point load or under the unit load, so RA is L minus X by L. So at C, the distance is X here. So it is L minus X by L. RB is X by L. So ILD for reaction RA. So RA, it is at X is equal to 0 is 1. So we have taken is 1. And at X is equal to L, it is 0. So at point B, it is 0. Then at point C, the value is L minus X by L. So this is the ILD for reaction RA. Similarly, ILD for reaction RB. So at B, it is 0. RB is 0. And so at A it is 0, that is X is equal to 0 means it is at A. At A, RB value is 0. At X is equal to L, it is maximum say 1, that is at B. At C, RB is equal to X by L, that is at the under the unit load. So this is the ILD for reaction RA and RB. Then ILD for shear force. So there are different conditions for shear force. The first condition is, if the unit load is between the points A and C, so that is, this is a point A and C, the load, unit load is in between A and C. And the point C, we have taken a distance of A from the left end. The unit load is acting a distance of X from the left end. So total span is L, so the remaining distance from unit load to the point B is L minus X. So now considering forces to the right of C, consider the force on the right side of the C. So here you should know the sign convention for the shear force. So sign convention for shear force is run, that is right upward is negative, and lup, L-U-P, that is left upward force is positive. Now we are considering the forces to the right of C, that is, we should take the sign convention is run. Whatever the upward forces on the right side should be negative. Now shear force at C is minus RB. On the right side of C, we have only one force, that is RB, acting upwards. So hence it is minus. So RB value is minus X by L, so that we already calculated. Then at X is equal to 0, substituting X values in the above expression, shear force at A is 0. Then at X is equal to A, substituting A at X, so shear force at C is minus A by L. At X is equal to L, shear force at B is minus L by L is equal to minus 1. So this is the first condition, the load is in between A and C. The second condition is, when the unit load crosses to the right of the point C, the load is in between C and B or on the right side of C and lies between C and B. So now considering forces to the left of C, here you should know, if you're taking the forces on the left side of C, the sign convention is left upward force is positive. Now shear force at C is RA. On the left side of C, we have only one force, that is RA, and it is upwards. Left upward force is positive, that's why we have taken RA as plus L minus X by L. So now substituting for X values, at X is equal to 0, shear force at A is L minus 0 by L, it is 1. Now at X is equal to A, shear force at C is L minus A by L. At X is equal to L, shear force at B is L minus L. Substituting for X is L by L, it is 0. Now, so this is the ILT for shear force. Whatever the values written below the reference line AB, it is for condition 1, and above the value it is for condition 2. So if you refer this, at X is equal to 0, the value is 0 here, that is at A. X is equal to A, it is minus A by L, so it is below the reference line, minus A by L. X is equal to L, it is minus 1, so it is written below the reference line. This is for condition 1, above the line it is for condition 2. So total it is a ILD for shear force. Then ILD for bending moment. So there are three conditions for bending moment. The first one is if the unit load is between the points A and C. So here unit load is acting in between A and C. The unit load is a distance of X from end A, and the point C is at a distance of A from the left end. So the remaining distance C to B, it is L minus A. That we can take it as B. L minus A is equal to B. So now considering the moment of forces right of C, the moment of force on the right side of C. So bending moment at C is RB into, RB is the reaction at B, into L minus A. L minus A is the distance from B to C. That is force into distance. Since it is create a sagging moment, hence it is taken as positive. So MC is X, RB is X minus X by L into L minus A. Now substitute the values for X. So X is equal to 0. MC is equal to 0 by L into L minus A. So that equals to 0. And at X is equal to A, MC is A by L into L minus A. That is substituting for X value here is equal to A by B by AB by L. So now the ILD for bending moment at C is at A it is 0, and at X is equal to A it is AB by L. This is the ILD for bending moment at C. The second condition is when the unit load crosses to the right of the point C. So now load is on the right side of point C, so that is the load is acting at a distance of X from A and lies between C and B. The load is in between C and B. So now considering moment of forces to left of C, the left side of C, bending moment at C is RA into X. We are considering on the left side. The moment of forces on the left side of C, only one force is, that is RA upward. Distance is X. So it is RA into X. So MC is equal to RA is L minus X by L into X. So at X is equal to A, MC is L minus A by L into A is equal to A by L into L by L minus A, or it can be written as AB by L. So at X is equal to L, MC value is 0. The last condition is to calculate absolute maximum bending moment. So absolute maximum bending moment occurs at the center of the span, so that is at L by 2 from the left end, also from the right end. So if the load is acting at the center, the reactions RA is P by 2 and RB is also P by 2. The load is acting at its center at a distance of X from the left end. So here X is equal to L by 2. The moment is RA into X. RA into X. X is here L by 2. So maximum absolute bending moment is MC is equal to PL by 4. So this is how ILD can be plotted for a simply supported beam subjected to single point load, maybe at the different locations. Thank you.